In this video, we are taking a closer look at the VideoMic Go lightweight on-camera microphone. And this one included a free windshield at around the same cost at the, as the microphone itself. So yeah, it was quite a good deal. I couldn't really resist. I wanted to get this microphone to use as a backup microphone that will record into the camera. If somehow my external microphones would fail on me, I would still have pretty decent recording. And this one doesn't require any batteries or anything. But yeah, you can see here the dead cat stuck to the box itself. So let's just actually remove this and have a closer look behind the box here. All of its specifications, Rycode mount, and of course, like said, no batteries required, which is an excellent thing. Just leave it plugged into your camera and you don't have to think about charging your batteries like with higher end microphones from Rode, like the VideoMic Pro and Pro Plus. And dead cat, I'm not really sure I'm going to use this because I plan to use the microphone with my camera in my little home studio, which is wall mounted and no real wind in here. But yeah, anyways, let's just get into the box and actually have a closer look at its content. And you can see here, nicely presented, all of the included accessories, not really that much, microphone and cable, and of course a little quick start guide. But microphone itself feels quite nice, a little plasticky, but still feels pretty decent quality. And of course you have a little manual or quick start instructions here, which is actually quite nice. And yeah, there's not really much to it, just plug it in to the microphone, the cable, and of course plug the other end into your camera or your recording device, and you are pretty much set to go. Just go into the camera and set the right levels, and you get the little TRS cable here, which is gold plated in each end. And yeah, fairly nice cable with a little spring to it, so it hopefully won't flap around and create some handling noise. But yeah, the microphone itself here, like I said, a little plasticky, but does feel quite well built. Of course, Rycode mount here, very durable, and creates a good separation from the micro or for the camera or your recording device or handle or whatever you're going to use this on, and the microphone itself. And of course, metal cold shoe here to mount it straight to the camera's cold/hot shoe mount. Let's just try that right off the bat here. So just plug it in and tighten it down, and you can see the only real downside, I think, is it sticks out quite a bit behind the camera. And of course you have the micro jack here and VideoMic Go. I'm just covering my serial number and that standard little golden dot right there, which is reminiscent of Rode microphones. But of course, just plug in the TRS cable here to the microphone. It records in dual mono, which most cameras use, but you can see sticks out quite a bit behind the camera. And of course, plug the other end into the microphone in on your camera and recording device. So yeah, you should not expect to use your optical viewfinder when the microphone is attached, but that's the same with most of these types of shotgun on-camera microphones. But yeah, let's have a closer look at the dead cat. It is very soft, feels almost like a dead cat, or how I would suspect a dead cat will feel. But yeah, of course a little Rode branding there, which actually has a second function. When you pull on the dead cat, you can actually pull that Rode badge there. So yeah, feels quite nice, and like I said, it's a free bundle included. And this is the little opening here you put in your microphone. It is a little hard to get in there. Let's actually try, of course, remove the pop shield that's pre-installed. And of course, you can see the shotgun microphone below that. It is all made of plastic, which again is not super high quality, but it is pretty sufficient or very sufficient for this kind of device. And of course have a very durable plastic. If you drop it and such, shouldn't really ding or scratch all that easily like metal. But yeah, getting the dead cat on there is quite hard. I actually gave up putting it on all the way because I have to peel it off again. So just for demonstrating on this video, it is definitely doable, and like I said, a nice add-on if you have use for such a thing. But let's just compare it to the VideoMic Pro and the VideoMic Pro. Way on up in the top there, you can see the VideoMic Pro is just so tiny, and the VideoMic Go is about the same length as the VideoMic Pro Plus with the cable installed. and of course it is quite a bit cheaper and doesn't require any batteries. So overall, the VideoMic Pro is a bit bigger. You can see here it does have the same design elements as the VideoMic Pro Plus, of course just costing a fifth of the cost of the Pro Plus there, which is quite a bit bigger, better microphone, but of course requires that battery and you need to charge it or use AA batteries, or that is a little cumbersome. And for my setup, I don't really have access to the back of the microphone because my camera is so close to the wall, so I can't really see that LED, status LED, battery status of the VideoMic Pro Plus, as I would just have used that one instead of the VideoMic Go. And of course the VideoMic Pro is the smallest of the bunch and actually made of metal, feels quite durable and well built compared to that plastic of the other two here. But yeah, plastic is fine and it does make the microphones quite a bit lighter, so which is also an added bonus of course. But let's just actually bring in the weight, and you can see the scale here, you can see 245 for the VideoMic Go with the included pop shield. With the Dead Cat, we are up to 328, and this is all in grams, of course. And you can see the VideoMic Pro Plus with the included lithium ion battery, we are up at 430 grams, and without the battery, which is of course mandatory, we are down to 347. So definitely a bit more heavy than the other microphone, but of course VideoMic Pro here is the smallest and also the lightest one, even though it feels a little bit more dense than the other two microphones. But with the Dead Cat here, of course, it is quite a bit heavier and comes pretty close to that of the VideoMic Go. But let's get straight into the sound test. I'm going to record it into my F1 field recorder from Zoom, and of course testing it, comparing it to the VideoMic Pro and the VideoMic Pro Plus, so you can get an audio feel comparing to those devices. Of course, there is quite a big price gap between the VideoMic Go and the VideoMic Pro Plus, even though I'm actually quite impressed with the sound of the VideoMic Go. And the advantage of not having a battery is definitely one that you should take into account. I have not done any processing to the audio. I've just turned up the gain to match each other in Final Cut. So yeah, just take a listen and let me know down in the comments what you think. So this is an audio test using the VideoMic Go from Röhde. I'm recording straight into a F1 field recorder. I've set the gain to high and I have a limiter turned on just to be safe. That will add a little bit of noise, so take that into account. This is a test using Röhde VideoMicro, recording straight into the Zoom F1 field recorder. I set the gain to high and I do have a limiter turned on, which will add a little noise, so just keep that in mind. So this is a test using Röhde VideoMic Pro, or VideoMic Pro Plus, or Plus to be exact. I'm connected straight to my F1 field recorder here, gain set to high and limiter set on, and I have set the dB on the microphone to -10 dB. So this is a test. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is a test. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. 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 So let me know down in the comments what you think. I definitely like all of the microphones. They have pretty good audio quality. But I think the VideoMic Go definitely lags a little bit in the lower end, but it is a little bit brighter than the VideoMic Pro Plus, which is quite a bit more expensive. And of course, you can always just process the audio in your video editing or audio editing software, so you can get the levels and of course the sound profiles exactly the way you like it. But yeah, definitely like the VideoMic Go. It is in between the VideoMic Pro and of course the VideoMic Pro Plus. And of course, no batteries required is definitely a great bonus. So yeah, highly recommend it. Of course, link down in the description if you want to check it out. Else, I hope to see you again in a future video. But that's been it for this one. Take care.